So glyphosate, basically what's happening, every year we're spraying millions and millions and millions of pounds. Just look it up for yourself. Look up glyphosate use charts and you'll see even from the 1990s, we are spraying an exponential amount more of glyphosate than we did last year. And this is contaminating the groundwater. Now here's the thing, we could get into the science of how this is disrupting mitochondrial function and leading to chronic fatigue and how it's replacing certain amino acids and enzymes, but I don't feel like that's gonna add to the conversation much, because the more important thing is you can remove this from your life as much as possible. You can detox this chemical with the use of an infrared sauna. I've measured it before and after looking at someone who did nothing else but a sauna and they were able to sweat out glyphosate. I talked with Dr. William Shaw, the guy at Great Plain Laboratory who created the test to test for chemicals. He said, yes, luckily you can get this stuff out of your body. Now, how it influences the gut, parts per billion, PPB, parts per billion, I mean, you can't even comprehend how tiny that is, has been proven to kill beneficial bacteria in the gut. That being said, you're being organic as much as possible. Even organic farms have been contaminated. Organic wines. People say, oh, Evan, I drink organic wine. Well, your organic winery or vineyard in California was right next door to the one that was spraying, and you're not growing this stuff in a laboratory or a greenhouse, so the cross-contamination is still disrupting your gut. And I've seen it on a piece of paper where people have these bacterial overgrowth problems. Now, is it just glyphosate? No, it's antibiotic use. There's talk now about the end of antibiotics and the post-antibiotic era. What are we gonna do? I'm not a medical doctor, so I can't prescribe antibiotics. And all the bacterial infections that I'm seeing, the average person has 4, 5, 6 bacterial overgrowths, whether we're talking H. pylori, which is a bacterial infection that can lead to stomach cancer if untreated. You've got Clostridia bacteria, including C. diff. You've got antibiotic-resistant strains of C. diff that are occurring in healthcare facilities. It's killing 39,000 people a year. That's a statistic that's from the CDC. Antibiotics aren't working anymore. So you've got the combination of influences. You've got glyphosate, you've got antibiotics, you've got other pesticides and insecticides, you've got fungicides, you've got miticides. And then last thing I'll say about infections, these things don't go away on their own. If you just go and take a probiotic, which is becoming more common. Oh, I'm gonna go to the health food store, buy a probiotic. I tried that. It doesn't work. Sometimes you've gotta come in and clean things out first and then reset the gut. Here's the cool thing. Herbs don't have any resistance. So basically, antibiotic resistance, these bugs that cannot be killed by antibiotics, you can kill them with herbs. I've had people come to me after they've done what's called triple therapy, used to be called triple therapy, now it's called quadruple therapy, which is 4 antibiotics at the same time to treat an H. pylori infection. We come in with a few key specific herbal protocols that I've created. We do it for 6 weeks. The H. pylori is gone. I had H. pylori. I lost 20 pounds from H. pylori and parasite infections. My gut was a wreck, so I'm telling you firsthand, if you don't fix your gut, how can the rest of you be healthy? You can't.